Do you want to subscribe to our channel before traveling the mountain of knowledge? Don't forget to click on the bell. Let's start. As those who watched our previous videos know, tooth decay begins when the outer layer of a tooth loses some of its minerals due to acid produced by bacteria in dental plaque breaking down the sugars that we eat. Fluoride protects teeth by helping to prevent the loss of these minerals and by restoring them with a fluoride-containing mineral that is more resistant to acid attacks. Fluorine also works to hinder bacterial activity necessary for the formation of tooth decay. It is a naturally occurring mineral that can help prevent tooth decay. Unfortunately, fluoride is the only chemical we can use against dental caries in nature. Although studies for new substances continue, the warrior on the horizon is not as effective as fluorine. So what are the facts about fluoride? Is there any evidence that he really does cancer or foolishness? Or are these just a rumor? Let's get into some details. We can take the fluoride in very different ways. Dental hygiene products, with water or food. Even in the air we breathe, there is trace amount of fluorine. Let's start with the fluoride in toothpastes. As is known, toothpastes are designed to act on the tooth surfaces and be removed from the mouth. Not to be swallowed. Absorption of fluoride into the body will be very low if not swallowed. Yes, various substances can be absorbed by mouth. For example, nitroglycerin tablets used in the treatment of emergency hypertension benefit from rapid absorption in the mouth. However, the best region in this regard, it is the sublingual region where the salivary glands are located. It is not possible to absorb a substance from your tooth into your body. In addition, the absorption of ions is relatively low. So unless you put toothpaste between bread and eat it, brushing your teeth is within the safety limits. In this regard, dentist warnings and instructions for use should be followed. Especially children should be put a small amount of paste on their brushes and kept under parental control to prevent mischief. One of the most controversial issues today is the fluoridation of waters. Countries like the US, the UK and Australia add fluoride to their public water supplies. In the US, fluoridated water generally contains 0.7 parts per million. This method is very successful in caries prevention. Studies show that in regions where fluorinated water is used, the caries incidence decreases by 25%. Also, fluoride is not only added later. In some countries such as China, India, although the level of fluoride in the water comes out of its source, it is over 1.2 ppm. This situation sometimes threatens public health, because it is above the internationally determined standards. So what's important here is, it is to use fluoride in a controlled manner. While it almost does not pose any problem in America, which fluoride the water of the whole country, in China, fluorosis from drinking water is a major endemic disease. As with many other nutrients, fluoride appears to be safe and effective when used and consumed in appropriate amounts. The amount of fluoride is tightly controlled in countries that intentionally add it to drinking water. In fact, exactly as Paracelsus said 500 years ago, the only thing that proves that something is not poison is its dose. So let's move on to the last question in mind. Even a very small amount, is fluorine harmful to health? Since community water fluoridation was introduced in 1945, more than 50 epidemiologic studies in different populations and at different times have failed to demonstrate an association between fluoridation and the risk of cancer. One of the charges is that fluoride affects the pineal glands and puts it into early puberty, especially in children. The pineal gland is an endocrine gland located in the brain which produces melatonin. The hormone, melatonin, plays a role in sleep, aging and reproduction. A single researcher has published one study in a peer-reviewed scientific journal regarding fluoride accumulation in the pineal gland. However, the researcher notes in the dissertation that there is no verification that fluoride accumulates in children's pineal glands. Moreover, a study conducted in US found no statistically significant difference between the onset of menstruation for girls living in a fluoridated versus non-fluoridated area. Another issue that does not fall off the agenda is the discussion that fluoride lowers the IQ level. Yes, indeed, a study says there is a difference of up to 3 IQ points between children exposed to fluoride and those who do not. But in order to interpret this, your scientific thought system must be very advanced. Simply think about it. Let's do an IQ test to the people you live in right now and those in your opposite apartment. Certainly, IQ level average will be lower on one side. Can we connect the reason for this difference to the different brands of water you use at home? Moreover, standardization of IQ tests is very difficult. Even quantitative blood tests can give erroneous results. In addition, since the 1950s when fluoride applications started, humanity has advanced more than ever in science and technology. This 3-point difference is not a meaningful scientific reality. In this issue, the best available science-based evidence does not establish a causal relationship between consumption of water fluoridated at recommended levels and lowered intelligence or behavioral disorders in children. Of course, rumors circulating among people are not limited to these. However, it will be boring to say that they are all unfounded. If you want to be more enlightened on this subject, we will leave the extensive research done by the American Dental Association on the subject. If you have any questions in mind, we think that you will find the answers in this research, which is based entirely on scientific sources. For generations, millions of people have lived in areas where fluoride is found naturally in drinking water in concentrations as high or higher than the optimal level recommended to prevent tooth decay. Research conducted among these persons confirms the safety of fluoride in the water supply. No charge against the benefits and safety of fluoridation has ever been substantiated by generally accepted scientific knowledge. But people love mysterious things from creation. While the words of people who spent their lives researching are ignored, negative things said by people who are not competent in this issue are more important. Unfortunately, some people use this situation. This mystery curiosity can hurt your loved ones one day. With the developing technology, it is possible to find scientific publications on a subject and listen to the subject from the experts within minutes. If you do not do this, you will have to live your life with false information while someone is filling their pockets. In order not to be part of this relentless cycle, use your mind. See you in the future, where there is no disinformation. Our next video will be a short story of Apollo 13. Who is Houston? Why the Apollo 13 space mission failed? Stay tuned. The sources of all the information said in this video are given in the description section. Please comment to make corrections or additions. If you still have not subscribed, you can subscribe and like the video. Take care yourself. Ciao, ciao.